The afternoon began peacefully enough with the scheduled rally in Trafalgar Square. Then, when health workers tried to march en masse to Downing Street, they found their path down Whitehall blocked by police and horses. A delegation was eventually allowed through, but then things became heated when a steward addressing the crowd from the bonnet of a police van was arrested. Some claim she was roughly treated.
I saw the nurse saw the person on top of the van, and I saw her manhandled down. From my distance, that was all I could see, but it was definitely manhandled.
Afterwards, the marchers set off along the embankment towards Parliament, where they plan to lobby MPs. Official estimates put their numbers at around 1,000. It was when some near the front tried to cut across towards Whitehall and Downing Street that the other two arrests took place. Eventually, the marchers were channeled back toward the embankment, but when they reached the House of Commons, they were confronted by more horses and another cordon. For some young nurses, it was all too much.
We were told by the police to go along the embankment and to come to the Houses of Parliament. We had a peaceful march down this road, and at the end of the road, there were policemen waiting with horses and with vans, as you see, to block us off again. They lied to us. They told us we could come down here to Parliament. There are only six nurses that have gone into Parliament, and they have lied to us again. We did it. We were peaceful, and we did what we were told, and they've still blocked us off, and it's not fair. How do they expect people to expect people not to get annoyed when they lie to us?
As the march dispersed tonight, the day of action over, union leaders warned that it hadn't been a one-off, simply the first shots in a new campaign to win more funds for the NHS. This one-day strike could well be repeated. Paul Green for Thames News.